Yo, what's up guys, it's your boy XpeK. So for today's video we're gonna be looking at some PvP gameplay. So this is my second ever we ran out of medals. So basically, if you don't know what it is, it's like a 25 kill streak inside Destiny PvP, and both times I've gotten this medal has been completely unintentional. The first time I was doing a bounty to like get auto rifle kills in PvP, and I was using the Doctrine of Passing, and no one could kill me with the Doctrine. It was insane. So that was my first ever we ran out of medals. I don't know if it's uploaded to my channel. I'm assuming it isn't because the past year I've been so busy. And then the second time is in this gameplay. So basically there's a bounty with, it's not Tess Everest. I think it's Amanda Holiday, where you have to use the last word inside the Crucible for the chaperone. And I was trying to complete all my quests before Rise of Iron, and that was one of the quests. So I had to use the last word, and I'm like, you know what? I'll take the last word out for a spin. And ironically enough, this was my first game of the day. I was playing with some buddies that I was hanging out with at DCC, and I have the audio muted because, one, it's corrupt, and two, it still would be muted anyways due to the fact that we're just blabbering the whole time and like laughing, and it would just be weird background noise. So we were basically just discussing about like DCC and like who we met and other stuff we were doing at the event. And while this is all going on, I'm sitting here on like a 20 kill streak. I'm like, holy crap, I'm about to get a wee round of medals. So when I realized I think I was on like a 15 kill streak, I was like, you know what, I'm just gonna camp back and try to get it. And obviously I eventually do. Now all the slow parts in the gameplay I kind of cut out. I just wanted to be, you know, as action paced as it could be. And I was being a pretty big scumbag. I was sticking people with fusions, but granted, it was my first match of the day and I wanted to do well because I wanted to complete this quest. So at the very end of the gameplay, you'll see that like I completed the quest in one game. I didn't know you could do that, but I guess since my KD like ratio was so high and I had so many kills, it just like auto completed the quest. So I thought that was pretty neat, and hopefully you guys do as well. So I know people are gonna ask me, they're gonna be like, hey, what do you use on your last word? So I'm gonna give you guys a little secret, don't tell anyone, shh.
Super
special,
special,
secret,
secret.
But okay, here's the secret, the last word. You don't necessarily have to aim for the head. So when I use the last word, I use like max stability. Now I don't, sometimes I'll be honest, I do aim for the head sometimes, but most of the time I'm aiming towards like the gut chest area. Because of the last word's recoil pattern, it's different. It's nothing like it was in year one where it was really accurate and there wasn't like a bloom effect to hand cannons. So in year two with the last word, you basically sort of have to aim at the chest gut area, maybe the PP area, because the way the gun kicks up, it'll like kick up to the head and you'll just get headshots naturally. And so that's the secret, shh, don't tell anyone. So yeah, that's how I use the last word. Just max out stability, use perfect balance and soft ballistics, and aim for the PP area, and you'll do pretty good. I mean, the last word's a relatively easy gun to use. I'll be honest, I am kind of sick of it. So after I got this gameplay, I was like, eh, I'm just gonna go back to like a Necrochasm. Actually, the Necrochasm is really good in PvP as well, but getting off topic. So if you guys like gameplays like this or just enjoy commentaries of me talking about random stuff, let me know what you guys think. I can do more gameplay stuff. I know I haven't really branded my Destiny stuff around good PvP gameplay, but I do have a couple nice ones saved up if you guys would like to see them. I do have the Doctrine of Passing one, I have a couple like Rumble clutches. So just let me know what you'd be interested to see, and I can always do another Q&A, whatever you guys would like. To be honest, I am just ready for Rise of Iron. Is it September 20th yet? Jesus, it's taking forever. So a couple things I want to say before I go is, I recently bought a new computer. Thank you guys so much for all the support and just clicking on my videos, maybe leaving a like and a comment here and there. I really do appreciate it. You know, if it wasn't for you guys watching and enjoying and, you know, giving me the uplifting comments to upload more often, I definitely would not have had the money to afford such a thing. So the only way I can really think of to give back is just to upload more with this computer, and I will be streaming once I figure out my OBS settings. And then the last thing is, I went to DCC and it was awesome meeting. I didn't really get to meet that many subscribers. I did meet a couple offhand, and it's just like going to that event and seeing Goth and Broman and all these people up on like podiums and, you know, sort of getting treated like celebrities was really eye-opening. To me, it's insane that, you know, like, it was like 3,000, 4,000 people coming together for one single cause from one game, you know, from a, well, it's not really a small community, it's a huge community. It really puts things into perspective for me, and it really makes me want to work harder on my channel. So this community is really good, it's awesome, I'm so glad to be a part of it, and I'm gonna do my best to represent it a little better and, you know, work a little bit harder on my channel. And when Rise of Iron comes around, you guys will definitely see that. So I thank you guys for watching. Be sure to leave a comment if you want more videos like this, and I will catch you guys again next time. Peace.